So these pesticides are used to control the pest because the plants, the crops are attacked by various pests, different insects and rodents and different kind of animals. So the pests are controlled by this dichloro, diphenyl, trichloroethane and gamaxin. But what happens is that the insects, they become immune. They are resistant to these chemicals. So soon they become resistant. They are not killed by these chemicals, and these chemicals are very much soluble in water. So by that they are absorbed by the soil. So not only being absorbed by the soil, they enter into the water system, they enter into the bodies of the other organisms, primary consumers, secondary consumers, and tertiary consumers. So what happens is that these chemicals get deposited in the bodies of different organisms, which will not degrade and leads to severe health problems. These chemicals, they are deposited in different animal forms, like in birds. Certain birds like pelicans, eagles, ospreys. So in these birds, what is happening is that the birds which are dependent on the water or land polluted or food that is polluted by these pesticides, chemical pesticides, their calcium metabolism is disturbed. That means every bird need to produce some calcium to form the shell for its egg. If the egg is laid without a proper shell, it will not become into a chick. So their species is endangered now, because they are producing shell-less eggs. These shell-less eggs, because the calcium metabolism is disturbed because of this dichlorodiphenyl, trichloroethane, DDT and gamaxin. So their eggs are not able to become into chicks. So by that, their species is becoming endangered. Their number is decreasing day by day. So in this way, they attack, they cause problems to the living organisms, either to plants or to the human beings. So apart from this DDT, there are certain other pesticides like BHC, organophosphates, aldrin, dieldrin, malathion, furodon. So likewise, a different kind of chemical pesticides are there. So certain pesticides were banned in certain countries, like in USA. So they banned the DDT completely, the usage of DDT in their country. But USA is making, manufacturing the compound for the use of other, for the use for the export in other countries. So in our country still we are using so many pesticides and insecticides. So the BHC is the other one, organophosphates, aldrin, dieldrin, malathion, furodon. So all these chemical fertilizers, they pollute the soil. Not only the pollute the soil, they cause adverse effects to the living organisms, because these pesticides slowly they enter the living forms into the other animals and to the finally to the human beings also. So this is one of the cause for the soil pollution, indiscriminate use of pesticides. Biomagnification. So the nutrients that are required for normal plant growth, like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, these kind of nutrients are found in natural water in a very low quantity. So that organisms, the small tiny plants that live in water are called as phytoplankton. The small tiny animals that live in water are called as zooplankton. So these phytoplankton, they have to collect these kind of minerals to carry out photosynthesis and for their growth. So as they are collecting these trace values which are present in the water for their growth, along with these, any insecticide or pesticide that is mixed with the water, if the water is polluted, so that pesticides are also pesticides like DDT, BHC, these are also taken by the phytoplankton. So the phytoplankton, it collect these nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium and other mineral elements. Along with that, these pesticides are also collected. So this phytoplankton is eaten by small fish or small organisms. Small fish. This small fish may be eaten by some bird. This bird may be eaten by some man. So here what is happening is the trace values of these DDT and BHT. If these trace values, even though they are there in the water, it is not possible to find out their presence with any instrument. Very negligible value. But what happens, these negligible amounts are collected by phytoplankton, they are accumulated. The value increases. So once they are accumulated, they are eaten by small organisms like fish. So this fish also contains some amount of this non-degradable pesticides like DDT and BHC. So many fish in the particular water resource which is having the pesticide residue, so they are eaten by the bird. So if it eat 10 fishes, the 10 parts enter into the bird. So what is happening? The concentration of the pesticide is increasing in the food chain from one organism to another organism. So if the bird is eaten by the man, the pesticides are transferred to the man. So this way we can see that how the trace, the negligible value of pesticides and insecticides present in the water are magnified to large volumes and get accumulated in the systems, in the higher animals like man and other tertiary consumers. So this is called as biomagnification. Now let us see the other cause, dumping of solid waste. So dumping of the solid waste, it affects the soil conditions adversely. So we have discussed about this solid waste dumping directly into the soil. So let us see the different types of solid waste and what kind of problems the each one is causing. So the solid waste can be broadly classified into three types. One is household waste or municipal waste. We can say municipal waste. Second one is hazardous. And third one is infectious. Infectious waste. So the first one, municipal waste, that is the garbage from the household, houses, offices, the waste that is generated is a solid waste which is dumped into the grounds. So this is a very dangerous one. Out of this municipal waste, some amount of the waste may be biodegradable, so it degrades. But whereas the most of the polythene covers or packaged materials or whatever, the thrown out appliances, electrical appliances, or mobile phones or laptops, whatever, the different kind of batteries that are thrown without a disposal. So these are all kind of municipal waste, the garbage that comes from the house, hotels and shopping complexes, commercial areas, that is all creates a lot of problem and decreases the fertility of the soil. And hazardous waste, it includes industrial waste, industries, the waste that comes from the industries as a process of manufacturing some product. The waste that is generated is just simply thrown into the land. There is no other proper disposal system. And medical waste. So the waste that is from the hospitals is hazardous. The chemicals are the medicines, the unused medicines. So these are all dangerous ones that add up to the soil pollution. And if you see the infectious, even the waste from hospitals, that is the body parts that are properly not properly disposed, and that human excreta, we see that in villages, certain villages, there will not be toilets for the people, so they go for the toilet on the open lands, so which leads to infectious diseases. And certain diseases are spread by this infectious solid waste. So municipal waste, hazardous waste and infectious waste, these three different kind of solid waste, it is a major cause for the soil pollution. So among these solid waste, the most dangerous and which creates a lot of problem, because some of the waste are degradable, like garbage or food waste, so these kind of things are degradable. But certain, like chemical waste from the chemical industries, chemicals and petroleum industries, petroleum, petro products from the petroleum industry, and metal industries. These three industries produce a very dangerous wastes which do not degrade easily. Certain kind of chemicals are stored in the underground tanks. So from the underground tanks, they seep, they percolate, they ooze, and they mix up with the soil and creates a lot of problem. Even the petroleum industries. So the petroleum is and the petroleum products are very dangerous. Even in the metal industries, during the process of smelting heavy metals like mercury, lead, so that different kind of heavy metals, cadmium, such kind of heavy metals are used and they are disposed into the soil, which are very problematic. So even the smaller setups, not even the bigger industries, smaller setups like dry cleaners, which use different kind of chemicals and solvents, and even the gas filling stations, petrol bunks. So all these add up a lot of pollutants to the soil. So these pollutants that are released into the soil, they cause so many problems. So that is, if you take the human beings, how they are affected, many respiratory diseases, birth defect, heart diseases, cancer, and loss of memory, loss of intelligence, all these kind of problems are caused because of these chemicals that are seeped into the soil. So if the soil is directly used for living, the people, they go for bores to get the water out of these soils. So when the boring is done, the underground water that is polluted by all these pollutants is drawn up, and if it is used for consumption, it leads to so many health problems. So the next factor, the next cause for the soil pollution is deforestation. So why deforestation is done? Why do people go for deforestation? So when the agricultural land is not sufficient for agriculture, if the agricultural production is to be increased, they search for new land. So what they do is they make use of forest land by cutting the forest. So that is for agriculture. Agriculture and for set up new industries, the forests are cut, and for mining activities, that is to get the metals and minerals out of the earth, for mining activities the deforestation is done. So that is for urbanization. So if they wanted to set up a city, they wanted to build a city, so there they need some land to make the city. So if they don't find any land out of the forest area, they go for forest area, they clear up the forest and use it for building up the city. So that is deforestation is done for living purpose, for new industries, agriculture, mining. So all these leads to deforestation. The deforestation leads to soil erosion, because we know that when the soil is vacant, free, and the soil is not having any plants, then the soil is very free. It will be easily affected by acid rain. It will be affected by the flowing water. It will be affected by the blowing wind. So the wind can cause the erosion of the topsoil. The water can cause the erosion of the topsoil. So overgrazing. The soil, at least it should be covered by some grass, even though there are no plants and trees. So if animals are left for grazing, they eat all the grass and they remove the roots, plant grass with the roots. So the soil becomes loose and it will be washed away. So soil erosion takes place. The fertility of the soil decreases. So the soil, the topsoil contains the organic matter and the microorganisms. So that organic matter and microorganisms are carried away by soil erosion. So when there is a forest, it will provide, it will make up an ecosystem where different kind of living organisms live together and adds up the organic matter to the soil. The fertility is maintained, and at the same time a lot of oxygen is added to the environment from the forest ecosystem. The forest gives so many things. In addition to that, it produces a lot of oxygen and fresh air. Carbon dioxide is used up. Different living organisms make it. Diversity is found in a forest. But when the forest is cleared up, the land becomes exposed and subjected to different kind of erosion, soil and air, because of the wind and water the soil is eroded. So that is the problem of the deforestation. So the next factor, the next cause for soil pollution is urbanization. So urbanization, that is the development of city culture. So how it causes the soil pollution. So urbanization means there will be so many people coming for their profession, for their jobs, or for their activities, industrial activities, to earn money. So the city areas will be overcrowded. So there will be so many houses, and the facilities may not be proper or sufficient for the different number of people or different number of houses in a particular area. So where large amount of people are living in a modern world, where they use different kind of products which will generate a lot of waste. So in case of urban areas, they use different kind of processed foods. The processed foods are packed in metal cans, in cardboard boxes, in plastic boxes, plastic covers. So all these waste material, that is packing material and food waste, so are the sewage that comes from the household use, domestic use, that is that sewage and the toilet sewage, the excretory materials are waste, that is all dumped. So every day from Indian cities, around 50,000 to 80,000 metric tons of solid waste is collected. So what are they doing with this solid waste? They are just simply dumping it off. It creates a lot of land pollution. So many of the substances, they seep down, heavy metals, they cause severe problems. So and sometimes what happens is that many of these materials are thrown into the drainages. They block the passes of the drainages. The drainages get choked. And the solid waste along with the food, see, the polythene covers with food materials are thrown out. Different animals like cows and buffaloes, they eat the plastic bags along the food. So in cows and buffalo stomach, it is found that cages and cages of iron nails, clips, plastic bags, so that are eaten by the animals. So it endangered the life of different animals. So this much amount of solid waste is thrown out. So they are to be disposed properly.